Wan Mazuki, Director of Kate UPM, and Assalamualaikum and afternoon everyone. In my presentation, I may use both English, Melayu and Bahasa Inggeris. But saya berbuat terima kasih kepada pengurusan tertinggi UPM, khususnya Profesor Dr. Roslan Sulaiman, VC UPM, atas inisiatif untuk mengadakan online teaching and also inisiatif untuk menyediakan graduan kita kepada workforce. So one of the challenging is in our academic or in university is how we can prepare our graduate for workforce skills. Yeah, so this is a good move by Kate to have a exploring authentic assessment in online environment. And also I would like to thanks to Kate, khususnya kepada Assistant Professor Dr. Wan Mazuki menyebut saya untuk membincangkan berkaitan dengan this authentic assessment. So for that, I will share my slide. I hope semua nampak slide saya.
Boleh nampak.
Ya, nampak. Okay. I think about this authentic assessment. I think the session we are not this stressful session. I hope we can relax and we can digest this topic. And then maybe after I give a talk is authentic assessment, like very simple and very direct session. I will like to discuss about. I will divide my session to three part. Okay, to three section. Okay, and at the end of this lecture, participant will be able to explain the definition, purpose, and importance of authentic assessment. That's one part, and the other part is participant will be able to explain definition, purpose, and importance of online environment. This is also is very important section for me, because in the situation now, in the situation of COVID now, okay, and we if the okay, and the third session is how we can integrate this two section, which is authentic assessment and also online environment. So I will provide you example and also example and the procedure, the step, how we can use the tools to do the authentic assessment in online environments. So before I start with this authentic assessment, I will give you a very brief overview about the situation. Why we use authentic assessment and why we don't use a standardized test. What is standardized test? Standardized test, or we call it a traditional test, it's like examination. It's like a test in the class. Okay, this is standardized test. So why we want to move from a standardized test to authentic assessment? Because standardized test only determine which student are good at taking tests. And another thing that this standardized test doesn't provide holistic pictures of student progress. This is very crucial now, because in our world now, the demand of the skills of our graduate is very much different than before. So we have to have a turning point from standardized test to authentic assessment. And standardized test also only consider a single test performance upon evaluation. So this is very a good assessment when we can see the comprehensiveness of the progress of the students. That's the best one. So that's why we want to move from standardized tests to another alternative, or we call it authentic assessment. All right. I think I want to show you the demand now. The demand for skill has changed. So if you look at this graph, we can see that the demand now not on the routine manuals. The demand now not on the memorize the content, what student learn in the class. Okay, apa yang pelajar baca dalam buku is not only the demand for the skill is more non-routine application. This is the highest demand now. Okay, another the topic, which is we want to produce a student or graduate which is high auditing skills. Student which is can analyze, can use critical thinking or creative thinking. This is the student that the workplace outside looking at. All right. So then we can see also the routine manual, the routine connective like memorize, non-routine manual also install the device is more less in demand now. Okay, and if we compare between 2020, okay, skill outlook, okay, we can see now that the growing skills that need in workplace, okay, in workforce now, is more on analytical thinking and innovation, active learning and learning strategies, creativity, originality, initiative, technology, design and problem-solving, influence, emotional intelligence. You can see that, yeah. How we can develop emotional intelligence among our students, okay? Reasoning, problem solving and ideation, system analysis and evaluation. So this is the growing skill in 4.2. And for declining skills, we can see that manual dexterity, endurance, precision, memory, verbal, auditory, okay? So non-routine connective, they become less demand now. Management of financial. Technology installation, okay, non-routine manual now, okay, become less important now. Reading, writing, maths, active learning, management, personal quality control, coordination, and time management, visual, auditory, speech, abilities, technology, use, monitoring, and control. So if we can compare between these two skills, growing and declining, we can nowadays in our worlds, okay, in real workplace, okay, people are looking for skills. The top skills in 2020 this year and also 2015. You can compare that in 2015, creativity number 10 came, but in 2020, creativity number 3. Okay, critical thinking number 4 is very important. Critical thinking is number 2. But problem solving still is very important. So we must prepare our students with these skills. Do our standardized tests can prepare our students with all these skills, problem solving, critical thinking, creative thinking, people management, coordination? Can our standardized tests can prepare our students with negotiation, negotiation So if we cannot prepare our student with that skill, so we must think what is the other assessment that we can use in our class for our students. It's very important. And if you look at this 2025, okay, we can see that the top 10 the top 10 skills, analytical thinking and innovation. Analytical thinking and innovation, active learning and learning strategies, complex problem solving. Still, problem solving is very important. Critical thinking, creativity, originality, initiative, leadership and social influence, technology use, monitoring, control, technology design, programming, resilience, stress tolerance, flexibility. These are all under emotional intelligence, actually. Reasoning, problem solving, and ideation. So if we look at this, top 10 skill that need in high demand, we can see that we have our student for problem solving, for self management with good emotional intelligence, working with people. They can have a good communication, good interaction with other people, and they can use technology and can develop along with technologies. So what we supposed to do? Okay, so based on that skills that we discussed just now, we discussed about the demands skills for the future. Okay, we must move now from standardized tests to another alternative assessment, and this alternative assessment is very specific because this alternative assessment is focusing on how our student can work with other people and can work with professional. Okay, and this type of assessment we call authentic assessment. Okay, so now we can see that apa tu definition of authentic assessment. Kita tengok apa tu what is the authentic assessment. So authentic assessment means providing assessment opportunities which are like tasks in the real world. So nampak tadi, okay, we discuss about the skills needs in workplace. Okay, so now we are prepare our student. We give our student opportunities. Okay, we give our student a task. Okay, in the real world. Okay, in the real situation. Okay, we refer to this definition, a set of method of technique for assessing the academic achievement of a student that include activities requiring the application of acquired knowledge and skill to a real world situation. Okay, kita nak prepare kita punya student kepada the real world situation. Okay, we give student the knowledge in classroom, in our lecture. We give student the knowledge. We give students the ideas. Okay, now we give them a task how they handle with real world situation. Okay, and according to Müller is very very famous. Müller, he had done very many research on authentic assessment. Okay, according to Müller, performing real world tasks or solving problem analog to a real world task that demonstrate meaningful application of specific knowledge, skill and competencies. So bila kita dah bagi budak, bagi our student knowledge, okay, so how they apply the knowledge, how they apply the skill, and how they apply their abilities, their competencies, okay, to outside real situation, to consumer, to a professional dalam bidang dia. Okay, like me from Faculty of Education, how I prepare our student for the real situation, okay, in school, teachers, students, okay, okay, with other professional. Okay, so means that kita sekarang ni must be creative. Kita kena kreatif. Macam mana kita nak buat satu assignment, okay, satu assessment, okay, for assess students, okay, not only just to check or evaluate, not only they have to memorize, bukan hanya setakat memorize, okay, tapi how this student can apply the knowledge, the skill, okay, the abilities, the competencies, okay, in the real situation. Okay, evaluated based on performance, authenticity, and suitable for the actual environment. So ini jugalah ciri-ciri authentic assessment. Real evaluation emphasize the real value of task and the environment. And penting, necessary condition for reaching the level of expert level problem solving. So bila kita buat this assessment, authentic assessment, we must think that, okay, how our student will become professional. So tugasan itu adalah tugasan in their field, dalam bidang dia. Bagaimana dia nanti boleh bekerja dalam bidang dia. Okay, it's depend on, of course, it's depend on our course. Kalau kursus, saya mengajar kursus apa? Saya mengajar kursus research method. Okay, so in outside, how they can present the paper, okay, how they can critique the article journals, okay, how they can give a review for article journals, okay. So semua itu berkaitan dengan apa yang dia akan buat after degree ataupun selepas di sekolah. Okay, so I also give some criteria suggested by Eugene 1998. Okay, an assignment in authentic assessment. An assignment in authentic assessment is authentic if it's realistic. So ini kerja kita. Okay, how we can have a task that really give student a task that really ikut apa yang berlaku kat luar. In the real situation, this is very important. Okay, means that before you develop, before you learn a task, you must study what is the problem in outside, in the real situation. Give that situation to your classroom, okay, to the papers, write in the papers, and this task is realistic. The problem is real for the student to solve the problem, okay? And of course, the assessment require judgment and innovation, okay? Jadi kalau kita bagi authentic assessment kepada our students, hasilnya adalah, okay, student akan not only student write the answer, but there are many skill involved when they are solve the problem, when they are solve the task, their judgment, okay? Their innovation, their ideas, their creativities. Semua terlibat bila dia buat authentic assessment. Okay, so that assessment boleh jadi satu assessment yang bagus, yang comprehensive and holistic, because they are not only student apply the knowledge, but also we can see the innovation, creativity and judgment of the students. It's very important, sangat sangat penting. Okay, and authentic assessment juga to do, okay, dia kena buat sesuatu. Dia bukan hanya menulis saja, but dia do something. Okay, alright, dia do something. Student will do something. Okay, replicate or simulate the context is which others are tested in the workplace, in civic life, in personal life. Okay, ini kita salah satu ciri authentic assessment is, okay, kita kaitkan dengan assessment with reassess the student ability to efficient and effectively use a repertoire of skill to negotiate a comp. Okay, so is very important because of I think UPF is very very concerned about this. How students can communicate with others, how our graduate can negotiate with others, okay? How they can give the ideas and negotiate with the ideas. Okay, this is very important for our graduate. It's a lot of appropriate opportunities to rehearse, practice, consult resource, and get feedback, and refine performance and product. So authentic assessment is not like a standardized test. Authentic assessment need a time. Okay, it's not like a one-time assessment. It's a take a certain time to solve the task, to complete the task. And the good of this authentic assessment is, okay, dia melibatkan holistic skills, skill yang banyak, a comprehensive skill. Okay, not only student memorize the knowledge, use the knowledge, but how they apply the skill and the knowledge. Okay, this is very important. I give you some example of authentic assessment. Okay. Some example of assessment, like me from Faculty of Education. Okay, maybe I can create a classroom management or lesson plan for the students, subject matters, or intended. Or to attend the audience, so who so is our audience? Kalau my audience is students, so I ask my student to create lesson plan, and then do a macro teaching. Okay, so dengan itu mereka dapat rasa sudah kenal. And if we can ask student go to school and observe how teachers do the teaching or do the set induction or do the assessment in school, that's much better than they can have a real experience. Okay, and how about the nursing? Assess among patients, health and plan, and okay. And the procedure. Planning, and then they can implement planning to the patient. Okay, in business, develop a business plan for a company in the student location and desired fields. In computer science, how about if we ask student to create a website? This is an authentic assessment. Okay, ada satu website. Contohnya. You nak promote one makcik sell goreng pisang, and how we can promote this makcik sell goreng pisang with one website which can access by everyone, okay, can receive the order, okay, and then they can interact with a rider that can deliver the goreng pisang, okay. So this is a real situation now, in a COVID situation now, okay. The problem with us in our society is not the big company, okay. Starbucks, McDonald's is not the problem because they have the system, but the makcik in the small stall, okay. Itu yang problemnya. So bagaimana our student can solve this problem? Two authentic assessment, okay. In science, record analyze. Client diet and come up with nutrition and exercise plan. Ni okay, ni contohnya dalam bidang medical science. Okay, macam mana kita nak buat plan nutrition untuk certain individu, untuk group yang tertentu. Okay, this is also example of authentic assessment. Okay, in business, student are asked to produce or market analysis report for actual product rather than writing abstract essay on the principle of marketing. So kita suruh buat budak buat marketing. Okay, how they can do the marketing in this COVID-19 situation now? How they can help this makcik jual goreng pisang to set up the business, buat marketing untuk makcik ini. Okay, itulah the authentic assessment. Kan? apa kriteria-kriteria yang telah digunakan. This is the authentic assessment. Okay, itu sangat penting sebenarnya sebab itu adalah the real problem now and we ask student to solve this problem. Nampak tak berapa banyak skill yang akan pelajar dapat kalau dia boleh solve this problem. Communication-nya, innovation-nya, dan dia punya apa teknologi device, okay, dia gunakan dia punya connection, okay, and how they can talk to this makcik to convince makcik ni gunakan dia punya website dia, okay, bukan senang, okay, that's the thing. And also the other apa field like property management, how student maybe asked to perform client consultation, role play, maybe you can use role play, okay, rather than we ask student, okay, you sit here for 2 hours and take the exam. Itu standardized test, okay. But how we can give the student the real situation? Okay, role play. Minta dia pergi, pergi ke mana? Ke buat marketing dekat bangunan CIMB ke? And from there, okay, how they can sell the product, for example. Music. Okay, maybe a spot a live event, just the performance in a live situation. Okay, tunjukkan apa tu rakaman maybe rakaman Gegar Baganza. Then you as student, okay, you evaluate apa tu the performance. So every each of the apa tu peserta Gegar Baganza, for example. This is a authentic assessment. Okay. So I give you a overview and definition of example of definition and example of authentic assessment. I think is very clear. Authentic assessment involves problem solving, involve engagement student with real situation. Apa saja in your field dalam bidang awak, dalam bidang awak semua, cuba fikirkan apakah the real situation that we can introduce to our student. Okay, we can write in the assignment. Okay, bagi kepada student. Itulah authentic assessment. Alright. So what is the advantage of authentic assessment? Pertama, okay, it helps learning. Opportunity to learn through completing the task. Okay, learning is not happen only in the 1 hour or 2 hour sitting exam. Okay, bukan duduk dalam exam 1-2 jam is learning, bukan. Learning is the process. Okay, so if we can give student a task and they can learn from that task, itulah learning. So kita dah bantu pelajar untuk belajar, kan? And second, motivating for student to serve a variety purpose, making a presentation powerful tool for convincing and teaching. So betapa bangga and puasnya this our student if they can help this makcik kiah jual goreng pisang to sell their goreng pisang. It's a real situation. Okay, and makcik ni from apa tu tak ada apa-apa jualan, zero selling, they can sell something. Okay, you serve a variety of purpose, making presentation powerful tool for convincing and teaching. So kita dah boleh dalam masa kita mengajar tu kita dah boleh tunjukkan mereka. This is cara dia. And of course student akan termotivasi. It develop real task skill, allow a range skill to be developed because the real world demand of the task. So kita bagi dia apa sebenarnya skill yang diperlukan. Some skills that yang digunakan, some skill that this our student use in to completing this task, some that skill also sometimes we doesn't teach them in the classroom. Kita tak ajar mereka pun dalam bilik darjah, but they learn that skill when they try to solve the problem, try to complete the task, try to selling this goreng pisang. Ada skill-skill yang kita tak ajar pun dalam kelas tapi dia dapat masa dia bantu makcik ni. Okay. Reflect student ability to integrate knowledge indirectly, improve student creativity. Okay, this me and my colleague, okay, in one research, I buat research berkaitan dengan authentic assessment. Okay, dia kan student can reflect, and after reflect, they can improve. Apa yang diperlukan lagi? Skill apa yang dia belum ada? Okay, macam mana nak cakap dengan orang? Okay, what the skill their needs? Okay, macam mana nak bangunkan satu sistem? Dia akan belajar banyak benda. Okay, and of course, this authentic assessment can promote 21st century skill. Okay, I think this is very common 21st century skills: communication, collaboration, critical thinking, creative thinking, innovation. So all these skills in 21st century skills, okay, you can have in authentic assessment. So sebanyak authentic assessment can promote the development of student higher order thinking skill in 21st century. Okay, dia boleh tu. Dia boleh this assessment can promote this 21st century skill. And it's also, you can use this authentic assessment as assessment for learning. It's a provide student many alternative way to demonstrate best way they have learned. Okay, and also we can also use this authentic assessment as assessment as learning. Assessment as learning. It offers a wide range of interesting and challenging assessment activities. It provides teachers with true picture of how and where their students are in their learning. Baik, bila kita cerita tentang assessment, kita selalu cerita tentang tiga benda ni: assessment for learning, assessment of learning, and assessment as learning. Okay, so assessment for learning is good because of we can use assessment for student to learn. Okay, jadi pelajar dia buat assessment, dalam masa sama dia akan belajar. So assessment tu digunakan untuk belajar, assessment for learning. But as we as a teacher, kita juga boleh gunakan assessment itu sebagai satu bahan untuk mengajar juga, assessment as learning. Okay, satu lagi assessment adalah assessment also can use by of learning, means that at the end of the assessment, we can use the assessment as a grade for the student. Kita boleh bagi grade for the student. Contohnya, kita minta pelajar buat practicum. Okay, at the end of the practicum, so we can give a grade to the student A, B, or C. Okay, this is assessment of learning. Okay. The advantages of authentic assessment, okay, develop a wide range of skills. Okay, ini kita dah bincang banyak tadi. Okay, include communication skills, decision making, use of digital technologies. Okay, so authentic assessment akan bagi akan encourage, akan growthkan this skill: communication, decision making, digital technologies, empathy ni more on emosi lah. Collaboration, practical skill, management of people, of resources, time management, working with uncertainty and specific presentation skill. Okay, so itu antara advantage kita gunakan authentic assessment. And of course, authentic assessment also can express this multiple intelligences. Okay, dia boleh encourage, or they can develop this multiple intelligence students. Okay. I think this is in education we are very familiar with this multiple intelligence theory of multiple intelligence by Howard Gardner. I tengok tadi gambar Dr. Wan Marzuki, belakang dia ada Howard Gardner. Itulah Howard Gardner yang propose this multiple intelligence. Allah, dia dapat jumpa sendiri dengan Howard Gardner. Dia pergi ke US dan jumpa Howard Gardner. No, it's not easy to meet this Howard Gardner. They have come once in Malaysia in 2010, if I'm not mistaken, in one conference. Howard Gardner datang, so bukan senang nak dapatkan dia. And this theory of multiple intelligence is allow us to accept that we have linguistic, we have musical, we have kinesthetic, we have visual spatial, we have logic maths and so on. So some people, they are very intrapersonal, and some people is very good in interpersonal. So with this assessment, authentic assessment, we can grow this understanding of multiple intelligence amongst our among individu. Okay, setiap individu dia ada kecerdasannya masing-masing yang berbeza. So dengan gunakan authentic assessment, we can identify what okay you good in interpersonal. So you communicate with this audience. Okay, you good with apa? Spatial. Okay, you draft the pictures. Macam tu. So setiap orang ada 8-9 jenis kecerdasan. And of course, authentic assessment bagusnya adalah very interesting. It's work for students also for us. Okay. Bila pelajar buat tu, dia akan menjadi lebih menarik. And okay, and for us, lecturers, teachers, kita akan rasa lebih seronok lah kalau student kita dapat buat benda ni and macam satu reward bagi kita. But of course, benda yang bagus, benda yang berbeza, dia ada challenge dia. Okay, benda yang nak kita nak introduce a lot of challenges. Okay, one of the challenges is time. Okay, designing this authentic assessment is not easy. It's a take a time. Okay, and need a lot of imagination. Okay, you nak prepare untuk satu task problem. The real situation task bukan senang. You kena duduk, you kena fikir, you kena consider banyak benda, you can imagine banyak benda. Kalau student go to this field, apa berlaku, apa after this, what next, so you have to imagine. Work through with colleagues, contacts in industry and getting student involved in shaping the curriculum can be helpful. Okay, and of course, this authentic assessment need support. There is a need to make sure that students are fully supported to develop the skills. Okay, sebab dia orang baru. Dibayangkanlah, kan? You also just imagine that these students are new in this profession. Okay, like me, us from education studies. Okay, Faculty of Education Studies. Teachers, a new, it's novice teacher. Okay, so they are not familiar with the routine, with the syllabus, with the the job of the teachers. Kerja sebagai cikgu tu dia tak biasa lagi dah. So they need support there. Okay, this authentic assessment. Need a lot of preparation. Okay, you need to prepare relevant activities to enhance their quiet skill, communication, high order thinking skill. So bila you prepare with this authentic assessment, with the task, you kena fikirkan apa skill yang terlibat in that assignment. Itu penting sebab nanti kita nak buat dia punya rubrik is bergantung kepada apa skill yang kita nak ukur. What the skill that we want to observe and measure is very important. The skill that you want to observe and measure must be in the rubric, and we must be prepared for that. Okay, and common career path for some student, the task presented may not be what they have in mind for the future. Okay, sebab bila dia pergi betul-betul, oh, sebenarnya tak seperti yang mereka jangkakan. It's not like they are expected kerja dia macam tu. Oh, okay, dia ingat kalau jadi pegawai kewangan, buat kira duit je. Oh, rupanya banyak lagi kerja-kerja lain. They think that if they want to be a teacher, only teach us. No. They think that if they want to be a lecturer, only teach in the class. No. In lecturer, there are so many things. Consultation with student, with community, with professional, okay? papers dan sebagainya. Okay. You may need to discuss and debate with colleagues how specifically real world assessment can work in your own discipline. Okay. Dalam yang sama. Okay, bila kita buat assessment, terutamanya when that course you teach in the group, dalam kumpulan, you bincang dengan kawan-kawan dalam kumpulan bersama dengan lecturer yang lain. Okay, harder to evaluate. Okay, this is also important because of this authentic assessment is not like standardized test. Standardized test is very objective. Betul atau salah? Okay. The answer 10 or 11 is very specific and objectivity is very high. But this authentic assessment, the subjectivity is very high, lacking objectivity. How about the reliability? How about the validity? How we can define the criteria? And how our rubric, our standard, can measure the criteria. Ha, ini kena bincang dengan our colleagues dalam group. Okay, apa kriteria-kriteria yang you nak ukur, yang you nak observe in that task. Dalam task itu apa kriteria ukur? Okay. Sorry, I just want to move this.
Dr. Tajul, there is a few questions in the chat room. Maybe you want to answer.
Alright. Okay. Chat room, ada tuan?
Dekat chat.
Okay, I'm still looking at the chat room. Maybe the one can
okay,
read the.
Okay, I can read. There is a few questions. The first question is from Dr. Manraj. Okay, what Dr. Manraj said is, as we aware, there is a dire need to champion authentic assessment as it assesses students holistically that would give rise to the future proof and job ready graduates. Okay, however, it would be a challenge as we need to address the requirement by ISO, MQA, CQA, and etc. That relies on standardized assessment. So the question is, how do we strike a balance and symbiotic equations?
Okay, I think for that, of course, I mentioned earlier in our presentation just now, okay, a good assessment is a comprehensive assessment. Assessment yang bagus adalah assessment yang menyeluruh, yang comprehensive. Okay, so when we said about this comprehensive assessment, okay, of course, when we said about this comprehensive assessment, we have certain criteria. Okay, some we can evaluate by using this format, and others maybe we can use other format. Okay, authentic assessment is only one of the technique or method to evaluate students. Okay, so you can combine this with the other technique or method in assessment or in evaluation. So the best evaluation is they must involve multiple method, not only depend on one method. Okay, so authentic assessment is good, but I don't say that you must depend on one method or authentic assessment method only. You can also use in your course to evaluate the students.
Okay,
I continue.
Okay, two more questions, Dr. Tajul. Okay, this is one from our YouTube's. Okay, so before, from the Ernie Muhammad. Does students prefer this type of assessment compared to conventional one? Does student prefer to this type of assessment compared to conventional one? What is your opinion?
All right. Okay.
Okay.
Okay. Okay. Thank you, Dr. Wan. Does student prefer this assessment compared to the? Of course, a student. I prefer assessment which is easy for them. If we say that okay, do this assessment, authentic assessment, or you do the open book test. Of course, everyone must choose the open book test because it's easy for them. But we're not look at the preferred by student, but which are more benefit for the students. Okay, so if open book test is a benefit for the students, okay, you can use this open book test because of course open book test also have advantage, have benefit, like how student can digest, can use high order thinking, can use synthesize the ideas. Okay, but we as a lecturer, we as a teachers, we must think, okay, carefully, which is the best tools, assessment tools, to measure our students' learning outcomes. Okay, so if that's the best way, then we have to a combination of these assessment tools. Okay, Tuan.
Okay, so we have another two questions, but it's okay. You can continue first, and then after this, we continue for the next question.
All right. Okay. Okay, thank you. Thank you for the question. I continue with this authentic assessment before we move to online learning. Okay, so for this authentic assessment, how we can develop this authentic assessment? Yeah? How we can develop this authentic assessment? First, of course, we have to identify the learning objective. So it's very important. We have a learning objective. Every course have learning objective. Setiap subject ada learning objective. So kita nak capai. We have to align our activities with this learning objective. Activities in teaching and learning, activities in assessment, okay, activities in classroom with this learning objective. So we must ensure that this authentic assessment that we are developing this authentic assessment will align with the objective. And apa kita punya instructional material yang kita boleh gunakan for this assessment. Okay. In online environment, what is the instructional material that we can that can support our authentic assessment? Is it a discussion board can support this authentic assessment, or journals can support this authentic assessment, or portfolio can support this authentic assessment? So kita sebagai teachers, okay, saya cakap teachers ni sebab sebagian daripada kita punya audience ada yang guru, saya tahu. So saya minta maaf Dr. Wan and Kate, sebab audience kita ada yang from school and also from university. So I cuba nak relatekan dengan dia punya environment. Okay. So what is instructional material that can support dengan kita punya assessment tadi? Okay. Dan yang kedua, define relevant task. Define what student will do. Okay, kita dah imagine tadi dah what is the task is the best task for our students, kan? Okay, given that assessment should be well authentic, start by looking at what professional in your field. Kalau saya mengajar budak education, okay, in faculty of education studies, kalau saya tengok my student, of course I will discuss with our friends in school, teachers in schools, okay. Apa yang perlu saya perlu ada dalam in the task, kan? How does this task make relate to your selected learning objective? Then kaitkan balik dengan this learning objective. Okay, kemudian identify essential performance criteria. Kita mesti set apa kriteria yang kita nak dalam kita punya task tadi. Make sure that you measure student performance is relative or similar to the expectation that would encounter in real scenario. Serapat sebaik yang mungkin, the criteria yang kita set adalah kriteria yang kita nak bila mereka deal dengan this situation di luar. Okay, okay, dia akan reflect dengan apa yang profesional buat. Kalau profesionalnya adalah nurse, apa yang nurse buat. Kalau profesionalnya adalah teachers, what the teachers should do in classroom. So our criteria itu mesti tengok pada situ. In term of interaction dengan student, in term of apa tu, how they interact student to communicate contohnya. So benda-benda seperti itu kena ada dalam kita punya criteria. And number four is, this one is part yang agak payah sikit, but then very important. Okay, after we have a task, so we develop a rubric. Rubric is very important sebab task tanpa rubric, macam mana you nak ukur? How we can measure a student task without the measurement skill? So rubric akan jadi measurement skill. Okay, what do we have inside the rubric? Rubric mesti ada kriteria. Rubric mesti ada skill. Ada skala, ada nombor. Then barulah kita boleh gunakan measurement tu. Okay, that's why in assessment, it's very important that we understand the four important terms in assessment, which is testing, measurement, assessment, and evaluation. Okay, kalau you ada task tapi you tak boleh buat measurement, pun tak guna juga. You tak boleh dapat nombor. So in evaluation, okay, or in assessment, okay, measurement is very important. Jadi bila ada task, your assessment, dia mesti ada satu lagi part, which is the measurement skill. Okay, a powerful tool for many assessment types, and they are essential component for authentic assessment. After all, authentic assessment are fairly subjective, and rubric help ensure instructor are grading fairly and consistently. So nak kurangkan subjectivity, nak kurangkan reliability kepada scoring itu, okay, atau nak tinggikan reliability, dan kita kena bina satu rubrik yang bagus dengan kriteria. Presenting your rubric to student before they begin the assessment. Okay, cakap dengan kita punya student, you do this task, this assignment, okay, and this is criteria I want to see: the creativity, the innovation, the interaction, the discussion, apa yang, okay, so you tunjukkan kepada student, I want to see this criteria before they begin the assignment. Okay, I will give some simple ideas in developing this authentic assessment. First, it's a good if we can invite kita punya if we can invite a stakeholder ataupun the professional to help us, okay, provide a session for real world assessment. Okay, we go to industry and we see the problems and we get relevant external party to offer real world problem to all of your student to work with. Okay, kalau boleh our student kerja dengan dia, solve the problem. Okay, contoh macam tadi, okay, develop one website to help this makcik to sell goreng pisang, for example. Okay, pair up group of student with client or group to work with life station, so that each group slightly different to work with. So we have many situation, okay, and every each of the situation mungkin akan ada perbezaan. Okay, tapi masih lagi dalam bidang sama. Okay, makcik goreng pisang, maybe the problem is different with kedai mamak, for example. Okay, kedai runcit, for example. So, alright. So you try to see every aspect of the situation. Invite stakeholder to provide formative feedback to students as they progress in the assessment process. Right. Feedback is very important. When you teach student, always give them a feedback. Okay. You cannot give a student assignment then after final they present without the feedback. Okay. So kalau you boleh monitor and you can give a feedback, actually in assessment we not only have a feedback concept, we also have feed up and feedback concept. Okay, kita macam tadi kita bagi tentang kriteria. Okay, kita sebenarnya kita dah bagi dia dulu feed up tentang apa yang kita nak. Okay, then after, bila dia buat baru kita bagi dia feedback. Okay, so feed up and feedback is a concept dalam membuat apa ni this to complete this assessment. Right, and the other one is require student to showcase their final assessment ideas and activity event to gain feedback. Consider offering prize. You give something. You do something with the student. Why not in the last class you do like one competition. Okay, buat kita buat competition untuk mereka tunjukkan apa yang dibuat. Okay, so but if we have many group, maybe we teach in a big apa ni many group in for the course, kita boleh buat competition among this group. Okay, saya selalu buat ni in our class, saya juga selalu buat. Okay, at the end of the lesson of the course kuliah tu minggu yang terakhir tu kita buat satu pelajar present. Okay, if in the situation now, we can student can present by online as like a kid doing in Pictel last 2 months. They have a Pictel poster competition online. So why don't we have like also poster competition online for our course untuk budak-budak dalam kelas kita di hujung kursus tu, di hujung kelas kita kan. Okay, so kita buat untuk that kalau di sekolah maybe untuk satu darjah 4, tingkatan 4 buat semua. Okay, so must have a something yang pelajar boleh tunjuk and reward from them. Okay, making real world tasks. Okay, authentic assessment in the online environment. The assessment criteria are essential to ensure fair and transparency. This criteria should be used for a student works. This should be written in such that guide performance, which does not limit student the one we thinking, okay, ada interaction dan sebagainya. When design the assessment task, kita mesti what are the most important aspect of performance. Kita mesti ada kriteria tu, okay. Kriteria untuk kita buat rubrik. Ini kita dah bincang tadi. Okay, bila kita buat this assessment criteria, we identify, okay. We identify what is the criteria that needs to complete authentic assessment. Okay, authentic assessment is around line and also Kaizen line. Okay, be open with student about area, use them actively throughout the assessment process to develop performance. Present. Okay, the task ni, kita sebagai lecturer, teachers, we must aware that mesti kita bagi peluang untuk mereka tunjukkan the diversity of the assessment. Sebab when we call authentic assessment, meaning that this assessment happen in real situation. This assessment not in the classroom only. They may involve a real problem. Okay, outside problem we give to the student and try and the student try to solve. Okay, so problem kat luar macam-macam. World. We must concern that student assessment is not one type. Satu jenis ya assignment tu, bukan macam tu. Assignment tu mungkin ada diversity. Okay. Sebab dia punya situasi mungkin berbeza. Okay. Second, we must give a space for unexpected answer, unexpected solution. Okay. That's why this authentic assessment is totally different with this standardized test. In standardized test, we have answer A or B or C or D or maybe E. Okay, it's a standard objective. In this authentic assessment, they're not standardized answer. Okay, and we get unexpected answer or performance or solution. Okay, number three, define your assessment criteria and stick to them in complex level. This can be helpful for students to know and what basis they will be assessed because there are so many possibilities. Tapi kita dah setkan kriteria-kriteria itu. Okay, cuma your criteria itu tak boleh terlalu strict sangat. Okay, creativity contohnya. Oh, mesti macam ni. Mesti tak kreatif lah. Okay. Kalau you nak ukur creativity and you want to student answer macam mana yang you ada dalam kelas saja, so tak kreatif lah macam tu. Creativity mesti something yang maybe different, lain daripada yang lain, tak sama, it's not the same, so it's a creative. Okay, then we go to next section, which is online environments. Okay, I think familiar with you because Kate have so many webinar program about this online environment. And online environment also involve this virtual space, computer assisted space, online learning experience. Okay, ini itu semua berkaitan dengan online environment. And of course, in online environment, we have two type of environment, which is either synchronous, yang macam mana yang normally we have in our apa tu lecture, we have a Google Classroom, Google Meet, we have a Zoom, Webex, and even we also can use a Putra Blast to have this synchronous online learning. But of course, we also have asynchronous online environment. Like we email them the recording, we have a chat box, kita boleh gunakan apa tu YouTube dan sebagainya untuk online environment. Okay. So advantage kita ada online environment, of course online environment have opportunity participate in high quality learning situation. Sebenarnya kita boleh pelbagaikan cara kita mengajar by this online learning, teaching method, teaching technique boleh kita pelbagaikan. The resources lagi banyak, okay, because of all not all in online and in internet. If we still remember that face, okay. Situasi ni macam tu je lah. Pelajar duduk dalam kelas and then we give the note by apa tu, letakkan notes tu dalam komputer dan pelajar datang untuk copy notes tu. But now all must upload the note in the lecture note in the system. Okay, so resources makin banyak sekarang ni. Okay, and of course as an instructor ataupun as a teacher, as a lecturer, kita kena lebih kreatif, lebih inovatif. Okay, kita have tu. Sekarang ni terus lebih untuk terima this new environment now, okay. And of course, for in terms of curriculum, then it's able to carefully reflect each comment from other before responding or moving to the next item. So The interaction tu dah ada sekarang. Okay, student can interact to the lecturers. So semua itu akan menjadi advantage. Okay, and now student can contact lecturer anytime. Okay, not only in the class, but they can have like email, they can use this WhatsApp group to communicate with the lecturers. Okay, and for, of course, environment in terms of technology, in terms of interaction, in terms of time, yeah. So in terms of resources and information now is dah makin baik. Okay, and disadvantage of this online. Sometimes student have a problem to access internet. Okay, ini semua hadapi bukan only our student in university, but in school, in our friends in apa tu rural and remote area lagi teruk, kan? Okay, instructor, ini juga penting sebenarnya because of for me, online teaching is like another language. Okay, before this, bila kita kata in Malaysian education system, kita mengajar dalam bahasa Melayu, semua tak ada masalah, semua orang ada. Kemudian mengajar sains matematik English pun ada problem. So they kompetensi in English. Okay. So sekarang the thing, but the situation now is before all schools, all teachers in classroom, physical, face to face. But the situation now is different. It's not in the class anymore. It's not face to face. But you have to teach by using this online. So online is another language in another medium, another language to we deliver the content. So kalau dia tak boleh, dia tak menguasai this Zoom, Google Meet and so on, they cannot teach. So I think kid do this training so many training webinar and so on, putting this lecturers apa ni this competencies in using this online. Okay, and of course kita juga dengan subjek tu, some subject is very difficult to teach online, contohnya macam practical subject yang perlukan amali, science, need labs, student in engineering need do something, this one is a bit difficult. Yeah, they have a virtual lab, but virtual lab is not a lab yang sebenarnya. So ini ada antara some subject should not be taught in online lah. Ada setengah-setengah subject yang susah untuk ajar secara online because of they involve the materials and also the tools. Environment technology, the disadvantage is it this technology is and critical. Sometimes also this technology is too much information. Makes a student confused, kan? Banyak sangat maklumat sampai dia tak tahu mana satu yang betul. Okay, so this is sometimes they have to refer to the lecturer, to the teachers to verify this information. Okay, so challenges in online, of course, first is adaptability struggle. Teachers, students, lecturers also have to adapt. Bukan senang. Kena adapt this new situation from physical face to online. Okay, and how about computer literacy? Okay, me and maybe Dr. Wan, okay, we are when we study in university for our first degree, okay, we don't have computer, okay, we don't use computer anymore. Okay, masa tu masih lagi gunakan typewriter untuk buat assignment. Okay, but now we have to teach in the course. Kita gunakan komputer ni dalam komputer sekarang kita mengajar. So macam tu. So is a very is very apa tu need we have to need training. Then of course I said many times to the teachers, to the our apa tu terutamanya facilitator pengajar, we need to learn this technologies. We need to learn. Okay. Motivation macam ni, saya belajar, saya cakap komputer je. Saya tak nampak pun yang lain. Saya tak nampak any, ada si Razia, ada si Nurul, because they are all offline. Okay, off video. Okay.
Dr. Tajir, you are offline tadi. Boleh share, you have to. Okay.
Okay. Sorry ya.
Okay. This is our problem normally.
Yeah.
Okay, kan? But it's okay. Hopefully everything's okay sampai habis, insyaAllah. Okay, continue.
InsyaAllah. Yeah, this is as a limitation because of tengah-tengah cakap terputus, tengah-tengah terputus, internet is good. Okay, so that's like now the internet is not stable, so it's a give us lack of motivation. And I think also one of the challenges in online learning is the attitude. Okay, still maybe we not have this problem much on these issues, but in school, do students in school, they have join the class and so on. Okay, and how about the teacher about when they and the lecturer this student sit on the chair or laying down in the bed on the bed. So mana satu, duduk ke dia baring? So this is the act of the student. Also the lecturers also sometimes are very like motivation is the problem. Sometimes it gives us challenges in online learning. Okay. So we have discussed about this authentic assessment, and so we have seen the scenario in online environment. So for that, how we can integrate this tool and implement it in our for students, okay? So advance in technology, not allow students to study entirely online while still socializing with classmates. Okay, ini bagusnya online learning. Okay, dia ada kelas dan sama dia masih lagi boleh teks kawan dan boleh bincang dan sebagainya. Participating in lectures and completing the task in authentic assessment. So bagaimana kita nanti nak gunakan this authentic assessment? Okay, secara online. Okay. Diagram dibangunkan oleh pasukan pesara. And if we look at this diagram is based on Bloom taxonomy. Okay, this is reviewed Bloom taxonomy, which is remembering, understanding, applying, analyzing, evaluating, and creating. And we can see that, okay, there are many strategies. Okay, many strategies that we can use in this online learning and assessment. Okay, contohnya, creating. We can use case study. we can use simulation. Okay, evaluating, we can use simulation, case study, lab report, okay, analyzing, online discussion, virtual lab, simulation, case study, applying, okay, virtual lab, simulation, game, okay, and for understanding, you can use survey, tutorial, animation, okay, and you can summarize 100 word or give feedback, 100 word, for example, okay. Remembering, okay, we can give checklists, okay, we can give digital. And we, if we see at this strategy, we can use this strategies ni, both for formative and summative. I hope you all understand that what is different between this two concept of formative and summative. Summative that at the end of this these activities, we can give a student grade, for example, okay, portfolio, okay, you ask student to submit portfolio assignment, and from that portfolio submit assignment, you give grade A, B, or C. Then we call it summative assessment. But informative assessment, student are doing the progress, okay. For example, like simulation or case study, only one of the method in the assessment. Okay, simulation ni dia tak boleh bagikan grade, dia cuma bagikan markah mungkin. But markah simulation plus markah case study plus markah quiz in the class plus markah maybe. Itulah formative assessment from the word of form, satu kecil, bentuk, one form, two form, three form, sampailah the whole form of assessment. That's why we call it formative assessment. And okay, and this is different with summative from the word of sum. Okay, so daripada satu assignment ini dapat dah the sum, jumlah markah tu. And you bagi dia grade. That's why we call it summative assessment. So this is the two concept of assessment, formative and summative. Alright. So from here, every make assessment relevant, integrate learning and assessment, integrate knowledge and skill within and cross discipline, promote connective development of higher order thinking skill, and create confident professional. Okay, ini kita dah bincang banyak tadi. So apakah perkara-perkara utama yang kita boleh buat tentang authentic assessment ini in secara online? Okay, first, creating engaging meaningful problem or task that apply outside the classroom. Okay, sekarang ni apa kita buat adalah okay, we have online, no, in, but how we can task for this online learning? First, we are create engaging, meaningful, work-produce or task that apply outside the class. Problem require the application of skill. So you imagine create one task that important to the discipline. Okay, include problem tasks that are cognitively complex, requiring higher thinking skill, and displaying creative problem solving. So, kita sekarang ni tengah fikirkan, think about, imagine what is the task for this our group of students. Okay, score this problem or task with rubric. Kita ada rubric that a clear standard that are applied in the discipline. So as you mentioned just now, we have many tools ataupun tools that we can use with learning management system. We have a discussion board. We can use blogs. We can use journal, Wikipedia, peer review, assignment, external link, rubric, and in fact also we can use another media socials. To integrate with this online learning, Okay, kita boleh gunakan Instagram, even we can use WhatsApp, we can use Facebook, we can use Telegram also online kan dengan kita punya assignment. So some strategies that we can more creatively about online assessment. First is we can capitalize on digital resources. Student online course will be sitting in front of the most powerful tools, which is computer. So we have to think how we can design assessment that use this online environment while also we can meet the learning objective. Learning objective itu adalah satu adalah kita punya goal. Okay. And of course, in authentic assessment, we aim for the authenticity, originality, a problem, real world, a real situation. Okay. How will this material help me in the workforce? Okay. Kita nak bagi student. Macam mana that material they can use in their real workforce dalam keadaan kerja dia sebenar. Okay. Use student environment experience. Think about how you make design assessment that capitalize their diverse environment. Okay, so environment macam kita cerita tadi is very diverse. Okay, and the experience is very complex. So how we can enrich their own and others in this learning process. And of course, can we incorporate with when kita buat collaboration? Okay, it's important to build sense of community and connection. Okay, remember the 21st century skills in education, communication, collaboration. Okay, problem solving, innovation. So how we can collaborate and communicate with others? Okay, one way to do this is by assigning group tasks and project. Well-designed group project helps students connect to one another and build important skill for working in team. Okay, how they can manage the people is very important. Okay, use both formative and summative assessment as we discussed. I explained just now. In assessment, we have two type of assessment, which is formative, okay, which is examine the progress of assessment, and summative, which is referring the overall or the grade, okay, in this assessment. So we think about this assessment. We think of summative assessment and formative assessment. Formative assessment help you better understanding student. Instructive needs students to know what area they are process, they are progress. Yeah? Online learning harness the power of technology to help students interact with course material in new and creative way. When designing assessment, you can incorporate audio, video, social media, collaborative wikis, creative research technique, and more to help students build valuable skills that can use in workplace and beyond. Ini sangat penting. How at the end of our assessment, the task dia boleh gunakan these skills, they can use this skill in their field, in their professional field, in their workplace. Okay, so kita boleh gunakan macam-macam. We can incorporate dengan macam-macam, termasuklah dalam social media. Right. I want to introduce you one of this one actually is one of our projects. Okay. Discuss and challenge board. Okay. I developed this concept of assessment. And thank you. I would like to thanks to Kate because give me a grant for develop this authentic board, discuss and challenge board. And so actually this grant my business member, okay, Prof. Muhammad Nazrun and also Prof. Shamala, one of the members of this grant, and also the RA for this grant is Ms. Kayan, okay, the RA for this grant. So we have developed this concept of stress and challenge, and I want to introduce this because I think this one you can integrate with media. The concept of assessment assessment, you can integrate with media social, okay. And in our concept, for this assessment, this board have six section, which is main board, my ideas, comment, my cue, chatting, and score. Okay. Okay. And for this, we have integrated instead, student can use group and use the concept of assessment just now, that the six in Facebook group, and use this Facebook group to have like interaction. Okay, so you give the task to the student, and student will discuss and interact. Okay, use this discuss and challenge board, and this discuss and challenge board not only we can
Sorry, Dr. Tajul, you are offline tadi. Okay, kena recontinue.
Okay. Recontinue. Okay. Alright. So, what I discussed just now is how we can use this main concept of the framework of this discuss and challenge board in online assessment. In online assessment. Okay. And we use this discuss and challenge, and this discuss and challenge board, they have six compartment or six section, and the main section, we call it main board. Here, you post the task, and student can upload or make virtual presentation by use this main board. Okay, so you can give a task to the student, and they can use this Facebook group to discuss. Okay, student can create posts such mind mapping, concept framework for discussion or presentation of assignment on their and their group members comments. Okay, so ini satu bahagian dalam discuss and challenge tadi secara online. So diorang boleh discuss secara online. And another part, yeah. My ideas, okay. Ini kita boleh apply juga. Kita boleh apply my ideas ni. Maksudnya, group and share opinion and ideas. Okay. And untuk Facebook group yang kita orang apply ni, dia buang komen. And we have my question section, my queue. Yang mana dia boleh create dokumen, okay, kemudian dia boleh share dokumen itu, and dia boleh ask question, tanya soalan, okay, and the group can ask question to other friends. Also they have chatting sebab student when they have do online they like to chat, they like to ask certain distance certain apa tu comment dan sebagainya, ataupun dia nak chatting, so kita ada ruang chatting. Kemudian kita ada ruang komen this area, okay, komen ini untuk another group di komen pula. They can evaluate another group work bila dia buat presentation. Okay. Bukan setakat dia boleh bagi komen, dia juga boleh bagi skor. Okay. So what I want to try to explain here is, okay, we have authentic assessment, which is involved with real world situation, real task. Okay, how we can bring our student to this real situation, but on the same time, still they have to meet the learning objective. And nowadays, we have to use this online environment. And online environment, we have synchronous and asynchronous online. Okay. And what tools that we can use? So we have so many tools. Okay. You can use Putra Blast platform. You can use journals. You can use a discussion board. You can use a Zoom board, and so many tools that you can use. Okay. And my group, I and my business group, which is Prof. Nazrul and Prof. Shamala, and also dibantu dengan my RA, we are develop one conceptual framework of this assessment conceptual of conceptual framework for assessment tool, which is ada bahagian untuk main idea, dia ada bahagian untuk my idea, my question, comment, and score. Okay, and this tools you can use as online dalam kelas secara online. Okay, and you can use media sosial. You can integrate with media sosial. You can integrate with Instagram. You can integrate with Facebook group. Okay. So as conclusion, I want to conclude my presentation today is authentic assessment need to have a real task, a real situation, and very important that in authentic assessment, they are involved with engagement. Student must engage with the task. Okay, and penting juga, student must engage with problem. Student are problem solver. Okay. Authentic assessment can enhance communication skills, higher order thinking skills, critical thinking, creative thinking. And if you remember that before I start with authentic assessment, okay, we discuss about the high demand skill for the future works untuk masa akan datang. Okay, this skill is very important. And this skill we can develop when we use this authentic assessment. Okay, and how we can use online in authentic assessment. Online environment allows us accessibility, resources, flexible time, bila-bila masa pelajar boleh gunakan. Okay, if before pelajar have to meet in the classroom, but now pelajar can meet in Google Meet, pelajar can meet in Zoom, WebEx. Okay, so they have a flexible time. They have a various platform to meet. Like just now, we use the Scratch and Challenge in Facebook. We also can use this Scratch and Challenge in Instagram. And some student, when I give the assignment, Scratch and Challenge assignment for them, they use in Telegram. And many other platform. And some of them, they have they give us something innovation, like in Scratch and Challenge board, by using this media social, they have barcode to register and so on to get the information. So pelajar dia kreatif. and the form to enrich and share smart, the confidence and seriousness of completing task. Ini pun sangat penting sebab platform ini akan memberikan pelajar motivation, confidence. Macam saya cakap tadi yang Makcik Kiajul, Guru Bisang. Then student really motivate when they can help to solve the problem. Okay. So authentic assessment is suitable to be carried out online because it's allow flexibility in all aspects and relevant to the workforce skill demands. So I think Dr. Wan, I think I conclude here for the authentic assessment in online learning. Maybe we can open for Q&A if any.
Okay, so thank you very much, Associate Professor Dr. Tajul, for sharing with us about the authentic assessment for the online environments. Okay, there is a few questions in our chat box. This is from Dr. Ramiza. Okay, the question is, Dr. Tajul, if I assign a few alternative assessment for the course, can I not administer the final exam of the course? So I think this question is according to the course outline. I think so. Maybe I can add some things. If in our course outline there is a final assessment, we have to do the final assessment lah. Is it right, Dr. Tajul? Eh?
According for the question, okay, of course. Mm-hmm. We have synopsis khusus, okay, ataupun course outline, and we have to follow the course outline. And then of course, as I mentioned just now, okay, in a good evaluation, okay, we must have a comprehensive assessment. Mm-hmm. Okay, and just now I introduced the four concept of assessment and evaluation, which is testing, measurement, assessment and evaluation. Okay, every concept is assessment. They have a strengthness. Okay, let's say testing. Okay, testing is a method. When we say that traditional MCQ, for example, or standardized testing, yes, they have a weakness, but still, this testing also have a strength. Okay, then among the advantage of this testing is they are very objective, and also we can measure or we can observe student level of knowledge. Okay, but then they have a certain limitation. For example, like we cannot observe how they interact, how they apply the knowledge with other situation, for example, in the real situation. That's why we have another form of assignment. A form of assessment, which is authentic assessment. So for me, for that, you can use the authentic assessment is one of your assignment. Okay, let's say you set for the authentic assessment, let's say 30%. Okay, and you still have a final exam for 30%, and the rest maybe you have a mini task for other tasks like quizzes. Like you have maybe another alternative assessment, okay, or maybe you want to student to do portfolio, for example, okay, or maybe a group task, okay. So you can have many tasks, okay, including authentic quizzes, role play, and also final exam, and all these we call formative assessment. That's why we have a concept of formative and summative assessment. Yes, Dr. Wan, we have a certain course which is only depend on assignment and only depend on authentic assessment. For example, okay, my student, they are practical in school. They are totally 100% is authentic assessment. But we must remember, because of the outline cost outline is stated that 100% from this assignment.
So, okay, thank you, Dr. Tajul. Okay, we have one more question from Dr. Manraj. Dr. Manraj asked, Prof, if I may ask, when would it be the best time to implement alternative assessment within a semester? Do students require prior basic knowledge before alternative assessment implementation? Do students require prior basic knowledge before authentic assessment implementation? Okay.
Thank you, Dr. Wan. I think that's a good question. Because normally we have lecturers, okay, or teachers, we give a task at the beginning of the semester of the course, right? So this is a difficult for students to understand. But as I mentioned in this talk just now, I mentioned that you must tell students the criteria. So it's no problem if you did the assignment, have to join the class, do the assignment at the week of 7 or 8. The one I hope
okay.
I know that it's possible.
So the on the 7 weeks or 8 weeks, is it the best, the Tajul? Your line is not stable. Okay, we wait for a while. Okay, the Tajul. Okay. Okay.
My line not.
So this is one opinion from Datuk Nasir. I think here. Okay, an excellence evaluation approach. My worry is that some lecturers might not be well versed with the real world situation, and let alone want to evaluate students' assignment. Nevertheless, the authentic assessment is a high order thinking evaluation and should be encouraged. Okay, this is the Dato' Nasir opinions. Okay. We go for the question from the YouTube. YouTube question from Muhammad Hazwan, Dr. Hazwan Muhammad Fuad. Okay, thank you, Dr. Hazwan, for joining us. Okay, the question is, how do we ensure students demonstrate improvement in knowledge and skills while doing the assessment rather than showing their existing knowledge and skills? Okay, how do we ensure students demonstrate improvement in knowledge and skills while doing the assessments rather than showing their existing knowledge and skills? Okay, any feedback?
Okay, thank you, Dr. Wan, and thank you, for the and measurement, and the best means to measure and to observe student skills in completing the task is you must use the good rubric. Okay. Dr. Wan, I think the internet is not very good now.
Yeah, it is not too stable. Okay. So I can okay. I can hear you. But, okay, you can proceed.
Okay. But in short, I can summarize, because I answer already that question. But in short, I can answer Dr. Azwan is okay. You must prepare the good rubric for that assessment. Okay, good rubric with good skills. Okay, and good description will really help you to measure and to observe the skill and the competencies. Okay, Dr. Azwan.
Okay, thank you, Dr. Tajols. Okay, so the last one from Annie. I'm not sure, maybe Dr. Annie. Okay, thank you, Dr. Annie. So Dr. Tajols, some students need encouragement to adopt new educative approach and at the same time to adopt new computer skills in response to online learnings. At this point of times, I'm not sure if our students are equipped with the advanced computer skills, but I have seen students taking my course making good effort to submit their mini project in the form of YouTube's video. Okay, so maybe you want to give a few feedbacks about this sharing from Dr. Annie.
Okay, thank you, Dr. Annie. I think, yes, as I mentioned just now, computer literacy is one of the competencies or skills that we need, either students or lecturers. Okay, we need that skills. So, yes, students or other lecturers, they are now have to learn and to explore how to use these technologies. Okay, I think this is very important now, and I think this is not only because of COVID, and this will become most important skills that students and also lecturers need in process of teaching and learning in the future. The other one, I think
okay, it's okay. So, we are going to end this session. So I just want to share here. There is a feedback from Associate Professor Dr. Nur Fadlina Muhammad Sharif. Okay, it's a great sharing, Dr. Tajols. Thank you. My students now prefer to submit their tasks through video compared to written documentation. This is also a way to personalize and implement differentiated assessment. So I have implemented authentic assessment in several courses, and students are actually motivated on this. So thank you very much, also Dr. Nur Fadlina, for sharing. Okay, and then of course we are going to end of our sessions today. So Alhamdulillah. Thank you very much, Dr. Tajol, Associate Professor Dr. Tajol, for your time, for sharing with us. So thank you very much, everyone who shared and asked the questions, shared the opinion, as well as all our participants today. Don't forget to record your attendance, okay, in the link that is given by the kids. Okay, and then we have one more interesting sessions on the 30th of December 2020. The session is the whole day session. This session is Bengkel Pembangunan dan Semakan Curriculum Berteraskan Pendidikan Berasaskan Hasil OBE. Bengkel Pembangunan dan Semakan Curriculum Berteraskan Pendidikan Berasaskan Hasil OBE. So you all of you are welcome to join the workshops. Okay, once again I would like also to thanks our beloved vice chancellors, our beloved deputy vice chancellors, academic and internationals for continuous support, as well as all the kit staff and all the teams for the courage and commitment. So once again, thank you very much, Dr. Tajol, for your time today. So if you have any feedbacks, suggestion, please do not hesitate to give your feedback and suggestion for online CPD training programs through our emails, kitlatihan@upm.edu.my. I'm also take this opportunity to ask for the apologize because sometimes the line is not stable. So we try our best. So thank you very much, and then see you again in the our next webinar and our next online workshops. Okay, so assalamualaikum warahmatullahi taala wabarakatuh.
Thank you, Dr. Wan, and thank you everyone. Happy authentic assessment.
So insyaAllah, alhamdulillah.
Thank you, Doctor.